Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina istafa. Amma ba'd, faqad qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi al-Qur'an al-Majid wa al-Furqan al-Hamid. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَصْحَابَ السَّفِينَةِ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهَا آيَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا wa maulana muhammadin wa barik wa sallim wa salli alayhi. My respected scholars, janab allama muhammad ahmed sahib, and my dear younger brother allama zial haq sahib, and last but not least my dear uncle nakibu sadat sayyid abbas shah sahib madzilul alim, and my dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. We are going to speak about Karbala and speak about Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Let's start from here. Let us give you a context of existence and how this whole universe of guidance operates within the Islamic system of Hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created man. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ التَّقْوِيمِ. Allah ta'ala says that the best creation, my best creation, is human being. And the reason, obviously, humans are better than angels, because angels don't have any ikhtiyar. They don't have any choice. And on the other hand, we are better than animals because we have reason and rationality. On those bases, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that human insan is my best creation. And out of the insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of the billions of human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected 124,000 prophets. So the best creation is the human being. And out of those human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a selection. And that selection is 124,000 prophets, who are the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And out of these 124,000 prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made another selection. And He selected 313 messengers, Rasul. So the best creation is the human beings, and out of the human beings, the best creation is the prophets, and out of the prophets, the best creation is the messengers of Allah, 313 messengers of Allah. And out of these 313 messengers of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a further selection of the five Ulul Azm prophets. Musa, Isa, Ibrahim, Nuh alayhi salam, and Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam. So did you see how the selection has been made here, my dear brothers and sisters? Humanity, the best creation. Out of humanity, 124,000 best creation prophets. Out of the 124,000, there are 313 messengers who are the best creation. Out of these 313, a further selection of five top-notch Ulul Azam prophets. And out of these five best of the best prophets, my dear brothers and sisters, there's only one Rahmatan Lil Alameen. There is only one Khatam al-Nabiyyin. There is only one Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So all the qualities and all the attributes that were given to the prophets before him, to all the prophets, all the messengers, all the Ulul Azm prophets, all the qualities and attributes of those prophets in one place, and that is Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Quran says, "Tilka rusulu faddalna ba'dhum ala ba'd." There is gradations, there's ranking amongst the prophets. So our Prophet والسلام, is the best prophet, the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has all the qualities and attributes of the prophets before him. Now there is a dilemma. There were prophets before our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam who were martyred in the way of Allah, who were shaheed in the battlefield. So the prophets, what Quran says, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in various verses of the Quran says, there were prophets among previous nations that were killed in the way of Allah, that were shaheed.
Shahadat
is the highest honor. Right? But our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't die in the battlefield. He wasn't shaheed in the battlefield. So he is lacking something. He is lacking the quality of jihad, the akbar, of the great jihad of being able to fight in the battlefield and get killed in the way of Allah. He doesn't have that quality. So you are saying that Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam is the best prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best human being, and he has all the attributes and qualities of all the previous prophets in one person. But wait a minute, my dear brothers and sisters. He lacks a quality. He lacks shahadat. He lacks the shahadat in the battlefield. And now, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, imagine hypothetically for a second, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was martyred in a battlefield, we would have still have another problem. What is that problem? The cynics would have turned around and the cynics would have said that the message of Islam is incomplete. The Prophet died prematurely. He died before his time had come. So Islam was not complete. So we have a catch 22, my dear brothers and sisters. We have a problem. If we say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if the Prophet had been martyred on the battlefield, the message would have been incomplete. And if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has not been martyred on the battlefield, then he lacks the quality of the highest quality of being a martyr. Do you see the dilemma, the problem here? Do you see the catch here? That if we consider him shaheed on the battlefield, for example, in the way of Allah, cynics, the historians would have written, message incomplete. And if he was shaheed, the people would have turned around and says that if he was shaheed, they would have said the message is incomplete. And if he's not shaheed in the battlefield of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people would have said that, you know, he's rahmatul alameen, he's khatam al-nabiyin, he's just a brilliant prophet, he went on miraj, you know, but, you know, unfortunately, he does not have the quality of being a shaheed. So it is for this reason, my dear brothers and sisters, it is for this very reason that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn. It is for this reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Huzur Pak to say, Huzur Pak says, Husayn is from me and I am from Husayn. Of course, we are, every grandson is from the grandfather. But what does it mean that the grandson, that the grandfather is from the grandson? I am from my grandfather. But my grandfather is not from me. Ana min Husayn. It means, my dear brothers and sisters, that Husayn did what was to be done by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is why we have a famous book in the subcontinent called Sirru Shahadatain by Hazrat Shah Abdul Aziz Muhaddis Dehlavi, Rahimahullah. He says that the secret behind these two martyrdoms of Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein. He says that to be shaheed in the way of Allah is two types. You have on one side, sirri shahadat, secretly. People get killed with poison, with accidents. Sometimes we don't even know who done it. So that's sirri shahadat, secret of shahadat. And the other one is jahri shahadat, the one that's done openly. There is no ambiguity about it. There is no vagueness who killed and who was killing and who killed. So that is shahadat al-jahri, the open shahadat. Shah Abdul Aziz Dehlavi says that these hadiths indicate that the shahadat of Hassan and Hussein, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein, was actually the shahadat of Hazur Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when Ibrahim alayhi salam saw a dream, went to go kill his own son as sacrifice in the way of Allah, at the last moment, when he was killing his son with the covering of his eyes, he was killing his son, at the last moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed, replaced Ismail with a lamb of sheep or lamb or some kind of animal from the heavens. And Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْهٍ عَظِيمٍ, that we replaced the sacrifice of Ismail with a great sacrifice. Can I ask you, does the sacrifice of a lamb, does that sound really great, even though it's from heaven? Is that a really great one? This is why Musawwir-e Pakistan, Allama Iqbal Rahmatullah Alayhi ne farmaya hai. Aise to har cheez mein, aaj kal to aise Musawwir-e Pakistan to mere khayal mein, Shaykhul Islam ne to samjha diya hai, dunya ko ke Pakistan ka asal tasawwur kya hai. Hum har baat mein Dr. Allama Iqbal ki baat karte hain, lekin ye secret Allama Iqbal rahimahullah ne farmaya. Unhone kaha Allah Allah bhai bismillah pidar maan aaye zibhe azim ahmad pe sar, ke Allah Allah subhanallah kehte hain ke zibhe baap jo hai wo bhai bismillah hai aur beta jo hai wo jo zibhe azim Hazrat Ismail ke liye Quran mein use hua, وہ امام حسین کے لئے یوز ہوا. یہ interpretation زیادہ sense, it's making more sense. The reason is because Hussein was not giving his own test. He was giving the test of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. He was not giving a test of his own rank. اشد الناس بلاء الانبیاء ثم الامثال. Hadith says that the people who are severely most tested are the prophets, ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلُ, and then those who are like them. But Imam Hussein was not being tested for his own rank, he was tested for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why through these Hassan and Hussein, the Quran says أَبْنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ. The Quran explicitly, with a definite text that carries with it a definite meaning. There is absolutely no difference in Islamic tafsir literature that the Quran, Abna Ana, calls Hassan and Hussein as the sons of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the shahadat, the martyrdom of Imam Hassan and Hussein, is in reality the shahadat of Hazur Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we don't say that it was not his shahadat, then you have to answer that catch 22 that I presented to you earlier. However, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the context of Karbala. Karbala is not a fight between two princes. It is not about two political ideology. Karbala is about haq and batil. Karbala fight is between good and evil. There's a principle in philosophy which says tu'raful ashya'u bi azdadiha. Things are known by the opposites. If there was daytime all the time in this world, you will not have any conception, any sense of the nighttime. You would not, you wouldn't know. a person in the Saharan Sahara, you know, he lived all his life in the desert. That person, he does not have a conception of ice. You know, the ice that we take for granted in our fridge? This person living in this tent, he doesn't know if there's a thing called ice. The point is, things are known by their opposite. And that's why, shukran, zakla. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, you see, Allama Iqbal again says about this whole incident, that, you know, Satiza kar raha hai, azal se time rose, charaag e mustafavi se sharar e bula habi. And he says, Eend quwwat az ayat ahmad padid, Musa o Fir'aun o Shabbir o Yazid. So these two forces of good and evil have been traveling down the times. From the opposite of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was Iblis. The opposite of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam is Fir'aun. The opposite of Ibrahim alayhi salam is Namrud. The opposite of Hazrat Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam is Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. The opposite of Imam Hussein is Yazid. They are both the representatives. They are both representatives of these true chains of guidance, truth, and haq, and good and evil. So this is the larger context, my dear brothers and sisters, of our today's commemoration of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And Imam Hussein is a symbol. He is a symbol of truth, of haq. If you follow Hussein, you are in the right path. If you follow Imam Hussein's way, Husseini Sunni hum hai na? Yazidi Sunni to nahi hai na, Allah ka shukr hai. Husseini Sunni hai na? The only path that leads to salvation is the path of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And I'm not saying this out of emotions, my dear brothers and sisters. There's a sahih hadith, for example. Hazrat Abu Dhar al-Ghaffari rahimahullah radiyallahu anhu. Wa alayhi salam aidan. He was at the Kaaba, at the Makkah Sharif, and he was holding the door of the Kaaba. Huwa akhidun bi bab al Kaaba. He was holding the door of Kaaba. Abu Dhar says, those who know me, know me. Man ankarani, and those who don't know me, fa ana Abu Dhar. Those who know me, you know me, but those who don't know me, this is Abu Dhar speaking. Holds the Kaaba's door, and what does he do? He says, O people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, Mathalu ahlu bayti, Mathalu ahlu bayti, kama mathali safinati nuhin. That the likeness of my ahlul bayt is like the likeness of, is like the ship, the ark of Nuh alayhi salam. Man raqibaha najah. Whoever sits on it, whoever sits on it afloat in the sea will be saved. Wan takhallafa anha. And whoever either sits on it and gets off, or never sits on it, halaka. He will be drowned and he will be killed. So the path of salvation, according to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, is Masalu ahlu bayti kama masalu safinati nuhin. Man raqiba naja wa man takhallafa anha halaka. So the Prophet says that Hazrat Abu Dhar, it is such an important thing that Hazrat Janabi Abu Dhar radiallahu anhu, he goes out in the Kaaba. Have you been to Hajj? He goes the door of the Kaaba. He shouts at the top of his voice. He says, oh people, listen. Salvation is with Ahlul Bayt. It is the Safina. It is the ship, the Ark of Ahlul Bayt. If you are on it, you will be saved on the Day of Judgment. And if you are off it, you will go to hellfire. What is the value of this hadith? This hadith, you know, I belong to a school of thought where we do not ever present in evidence any weak or any fabricated hadith. That is my school of thought. No weak hadith, no fabrication, none of that. Only what is authentic and what is genuine. Imam At-Tibi, for example, Hazrat Allama Imam At-Tibi, in his Sharh Mishkat al-Masabih, he is an 8th century hadith master, and he is making a commentary on Mishkat al-Masabih, which is the collection of numerous hadiths from Bukhari, Muslim, Siyasitta, and others, and on various subjects. So it's a collection made out of the many other books, and he is making a commentary on this hadith, Imam At-Tibi in the 8th century. What does he say about this hadith? That my Ahlul Bayt are like the ark, Noah's ark, and if you are with them, you'll be safe. And if you are not with them, and if you're not on their ship, then you will perish and you will drown. Imam At-Tibi says, هذا حديث صحيح, that this hadith is sahih. He didn't say Hassan. Hassan is a lesser degree. He didn't say ضعيف or مرسل or منقطع. He says هذا حديث صحيح لا مجال للرد فيه. He goes, it is impossible to refute this hadith's authentic chain. I am not saying it. I'm not a muhaddis. I can't give you the hadith authentication. But a great imam of hadith, of Ahlul Sunnah, says that this is a sahih hadith, and it's almost impossible to refute its authenticity. We have two places. So pehle sarkar ne farmaya ki meri jo ummat hogi wo jo isai the wo 71 firqon mein bate aur yahudi 72 mein batenge aur meri ummat jo hai wo 73 mein batenge. ये हदीस यहाँ खत्म हो जाती है. इसके नीचे एक और हदीस है जिसमें कहा कि ईसाई 71 में, यहूदी 72 में और मुसलमान 73 में, और कुल्लहुम फिन्नार या कुल्लहा फिन्नार ललवाहिदा, और सारे जहन्नम में जाएंगे मुसलमानों के 73 फिरके सिवाय एक. ये हदीस अक्सर आपने उलमा से सुनी होगी और काफी लोगों ने लिखा भी है. लेकिन अब इमाम शौकानी फरमाते हैं कि ये जो एडिशन है ना कि सारे जहन्नम में सिर्फ एक जन्नत में, वो कहते हैं कि ये ज्यादत फासिदा है, ये सही नहीं है. वो कहते हैं कि जमातुन मिनल मुहद्दिसीन, एक मुहद्दिसीन की बड़ी जमात ने ये जो एडिशन है ना कि सारे जहन्नम में सिर्फ एक जन्नत में, वो कहते हैं ये ज्यादत फासिदा है. इमाम इब्नुल वजीर अलवासिम अलकवासिम में भी फरमाते हैं कि ये मौजू है. इब्न हजम ने भी कहा कि ये मौजू है. मैं इसके बारे में आर्गुमेंट आपके साथ नहीं कर रहा हूँ. मैं सिर्फ ये बता रहा हूँ कि एक तो मशहूर हदीस है ना कि फलां फलां फलां, और जिसको इतने बड़े बड़े मुहद्दिसीन ने ज़ईफ कर दिया या इसको मौजू कह दिया ज्यादत फासदा. लेकिन ये हदीस जो है मासलो अहले बैती, कि मेरे अहले बैत की मिसाल कश्ती सफीने नू की है, जो उस पर बैठेगा निजात पाएगा और जो उससे उतरेगा वो हलाक हो जाएगा. वो 73 फिरकों वाली तो क्वेश्चनेबल होगी ना, मुहद्दिसीन ने कर दिया उसको. और वैसे भी कुरान पाक में है कुन तुम खैरा उम्मतें, कि तुम बेस्ट उम्मत हो. तो कैसी यार तुम बेस्ट उम्मत हो कि ईसाई तो तुमसे अच्छे रह गए, वो तो 71 में बटे थे. यहूदी तुमसे अच्छे रह गए, वो तो 72 में बटे थे. तुम तो इतनी बेस्ट हो गए, तुम 73 में बट गए. बहरहाल ये मेरा पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू यहाँ इस वक्त मैंने ऐसे आपसे जिक्र कर दिया ताकि आपको निजात का पता चले कि वो जिस पे निजात दूसरी तरफ से कायम की जा रही है वो हदीस क्वेश्चनेबल है. लेकिन ये हदीस तो क्वेश्चनेबल नहीं है ना. हाजा हदीस सुन सही, ये तो सही हदीस है. तो सरकार ने क्या फरमाया, मेरे अहले बैत की मिसाल सफीना नू की तरह है. तो अब जरा देखें कि सरकार ने खुद कहा सफीना नू की तरह है, अब देखें कि ये सफीना नू कैसा था, ये सफीना नू का क्या सिस्टम. प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सेज माय अहलुल बैत, and by the way, Ahlul Bayt means Fatima, Hassan, Hussein, Ali. Allahumma haulai Ahlul Bayt. Hasar hai isme. Ek alag discussion hai. But azwaj mutahharat bhi Ahlul Bayt hain, lekin wo jo Ahlul Bayt hain, they are Ahlul Bayt sabab. Aur Banu Hashim bhi Ahlul Bayt hain, lekin wo Ahlul Bayt nasab. Aur Salman Farsi wo bhi Ahlul Bayt hain, lekin wo Ahlul Bayt khidmat. और पंचतन पाक भी अहले बैत हैं, लेकिन वो अहले बैत विलादत और तहीर के मिस्ताक हैं. सो अहले बैत सारे हैं, लेकिन ये वाली जो अहले बैत है ना, ये जरा डिफरेंट वाली अहले बैत है. मसल व अहले बैत, तो वो मेरे यू नो माय अहले बैत इज लाइक द द द नोवाज आर्क, हूएवर बोर्ड्स इट will be saved. And whoever does not board this ship will drown and will perish. Right? This is the hadith. So the Prophet says, the likeness of my al-bayt is the likeness of the Noah's Ark. Right? So what is, how was the Noah's Ark like? What was it like? We look the Quran Sharif. Quran Pak will tell us what the Noah's Ark is like. The Quran says, فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَصْحَابَ السَّفِينَةِ, that we, Allah Ta'ala says, that we saved Nuh alayhi salam, وَأَصْحَابَ السَّفِينَةِ, and the companions of the ship. Ashab of the ship. وَجَعَلْنَا آيَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, and we made this ship, Noah's Ark, as a sign of truth for the world. Right. So people were saved on it, and this Noah's Ark is a sign of truth for the world. Right? Then Allah Ta'ala says to Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, this was the function of it. فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ, it is protecting and saving people, and it is a sign of truth. Right? I don't have to explain every word because I think we are slowly moving towards the end. Right. So the next, Allah Ta'ala says, when Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam was making this boat, with making this ship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, wasna al-fulka, that make this boat, this ship, bi-ayunina, in front of our eyes, in front of our control. So from this we know that Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam did not make it. He did not have a choice in making the boat, but Allah Ta'ala made the boat for him. The ship of Nuh alayhi salam was made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was ordered by Allah Ta'ala, and it was being built under the instructions. Wahyina. And then Allah Ta'ala inspired Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam to build the boat under the instructions of the revelation. So it wasn't an independent endeavor, it was under the instructions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then there's a very dangerous, I shouldn't say dangerous, but then very thoughtful verse after this. وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. Allah Ta'ala says, listen, Nuh alayhi salam, Nuh, don't even ask me. Don't even ask me to save those who have committed error and who have done zulm. So Hazrat Musa alayhi salam was clearly told, no, you can't have. So the point here is, if the boat of Nuh, the ark of Nuh alayhi salam, is the like of Ahlul Bayt, then this is also significant that we know what the ark of Nuh alayhi salam is like. The ark of Nuh, he is not allowed to have the people who are against his mission or who are against his thing to be boarded on. And this is for Sadat-e Kiram. You know, the Sayyid, Allah Ta'ala says, Laysa min ahlik, that your son is not from, his son was not on the mission of Nuh alayhi salam, therefore you ain't coming on the boat. O Sadat-e Kiram, if you don't say, if you're not with Ya Ali and Ya Hassan and Ya Hussein and Ya Fatima, don't bother coming on the ship of salvation of Ahlul Bayt. Laysa min ahlik. So the next thing is, I'm just finishing. So these are the kind of things. Do you see how the boat is operating and how the people on the boat, how the people on the ship, it's identical. Right? And then it says, and this is a very thought-provoking verse. There's a thought-provoking verse. Allah Ta'ala says, وَحْمَلْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ ذَاتِ الْوَاحٍ وَدُسُرٍ, that we carried Nuh alayhi salam upon planks of wood and nails. What? मतलब ये क्या हुआ भाई? अब देखो ना आप किबला अलामा साहब, मैं आपसे कहूँ कि आप मुझे कहें जी किधर से आए हैं, मतलब कोई दरिया से आए हैं, तो मैं आप मुझसे पूछें भाई आप कहाँ से आए, मैं कहूँ जी मैं तख्तों पर और कीलों पे बैठ गया हूँ, आप कहेंगे यार आप चंगे भले तो पढ़े लिखे आदमी हैं, ये क्या कह रहे हो, सीधी तरह कश्ती कह दो। अल्लाह ताला से वो हमल ना हो अला जाते अलवाहिन वो दूसर, तो वी कैरिड हिम ऑन नेल्स एंड प्लैंक्स, तो पता चला मेरे दोस्तों کہ جو کشتی ہے وہ دو چیزوں سے بنتی ہے. تب ہی حضور پاک نے کہا فرمایا تھا انی تارکن فیکم مستقلین کتاب اللہ و اطرتی اہل بیتی. I'm leaving two weighty things behind, the book of God and my Ahlul Bayt, my itrat, my descendants, itrati. And in tamassaktum, if you hold steadfast to them, lan tadillu ba'di, you will never be misguided. Now this is Hadith al-Thaqalain, by the way. Hadith al-Thaqalain is reported by Sahih Muslim, Jami Tirmidhi, Imam Nasai, Musnad Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and a host of lots of books. This hadith is mutawatir bil ma'na. Right? The hadith that we normally read, that I'm leaving two things behind you, Kitabullah wa Sunnati, of course, in meaning, it's a perfect hadith, because hame agar hadith na bhi ho, to Quran Pak kehta hai, ki jo Rasul Pak tumhe de de le lo. So hadith is proven from. But on the level of authentication, Kitabullah and Sunnati, for a start, is not in any of the six books of hadith. Siyasitta. It's not there. It's in Bahaki and Darakutni. And some places is Mursal. Lekin aapne ye, aap dekhte nahi hai, din raat ko Kitabullah Sunnati log padhte hain. وہ حدیث سکلین تو کوئی نہیں پڑھتا. یہ تو آپ منہاج القرآن کو نہیں کہہ رہا ہوں, آپ نے تو کتابیں چھاپ چھاپ کے دنیا کو معرفت عطا کر دی ہے. انی تارک ان فیکم سکلین, لیونگ ٹو تھنگز. سو حملنا ہو علی ذات الواح و دسر. دس از واٹ آئی ایم گوئنگ ٹو سے از بٹ ہیوی. سو You know, nails and planks. If you ever, you know the old shipbuilding, the people in the old times with the shipbuilding, right? So in the shipbuilding, what happens is that if there was a ship, so if one of the planks is faulty, they will take it out and they will replace it. And this way, over 20, 30 years, the ship that you started with is no longer the ship that exists today. Because the boards and nails have been replaced. So in the beginning, boards and nails, one by one change. So now you know. Inni tarikun fikum astakalain. Sheikh, please come. Inni tarikun fikum astakalain. That my Ahlul Bayt are like the Noah's Ark. Now this Ark is made of nails and planks. Nails and planks over the years and period of time can be replaced. Can be replaced into a new one. So the nails and planks are being replaced slowly and slowly and slowly. So now you know, inni tarikun fikum astakalain, I'm leaving my book. So in the beginning, the Ahlul Bayt, wa Ali, Fatima, Hassan, and when the ship started sailing, you have got who? You have got Zainul Abidin. After that, you've got Jafar al-Sadiq, Bakir, Muhammad al-Bakir, Jafar al-Sadiq. And as the boat continues, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the Safina Anu. Did you get the point about the nails and planks? So this is the Safina of Ahlul Bayt. Now, welcome, dear Shaykh. So now, this is the Safina of Hazrat Nu alayhi salam. So do you understand, do you know, I mean, of course you know that now we have the salvation in Islam. Salvation in our deen, in Islam, depends on us being holding steadfast to the Ahlul Bayt, the Atahar alayhim as-salam. There is no love of Ahlul Bayt, there is no salvation. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. Hadith al-Thaqalain, by the way, Rasulullah stated the hadith at the Arafat. That's once. He stated the hadith then at Ghadir-e-Khum. Then he stated the hadith in Masjid al-Nabawi. Then on his deathbed, Abu Hayyan al-Unusi, who is a Spanish scholar, al-Bahr al-Muhit, he in the Muqaddimah writes that one of the last things that Hazur Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said when going away from this world was, Inni tarikun fikum thakalain kitabullahi wa itrati ahlul bayti. I'm leaving two things behind you, the book of Allah and my Ahlul Bayt. One of the last things that Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam said. So the salvation, my dear brothers and sisters, depends on us being holding steadfast to the Ahlul Bayt. Holding steadfast to the Ahlul Bayt. And this is why, my dear brothers and sisters, in the 61 after Hijrah, when Yazid sat on the throne. This Yazid, who is an open drinker, who has, I mean, there are things, wallahi al-azim, I can't say in front of you because my mothers and my sisters are sitting there. That's how evil Yazid was. Yazid came on, sat on the throne, pressurized everybody to take bayat. The whole world slowly and slowly gave bayat. But Imam Hussein alayhi salam said no to the bayat of Yazid. Because why? Because he was the inheritor of the ship of salvation. If Hussein had signed, if Hussein had given allegiance to Yazid, then what would have happened, my dear brothers and sisters? Yazid would have had a legitimacy. He would have had jawaz to distort and fabricate hadith and distort our religion. He would have changed the whole thing. He was already drinking. He was always with dancing girls and dancing boys. He was already doing all these things, being drunk on Hajj. He went on Hajj and he was drunk on Hajj. Arafat mein Yazid ja raha hai janab drunk hoke. Akhri Hajj apne takht pe baithne se pehle Ibn Asir ne Kamil mein likha. So the point is that Yazid is not a good character. So he wanted bayat of Imam Hussein, and Imam Hussein alayhi salam says, people like me don't do bayat of people like you. I am the son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. If I am the only one left. And if I do the bayat of you or Yazid, then that means Yazid has a license. He has a license because sari dunya usko khalifa maan lena. Imam Hussain nahi maane, koi dunya wala usko khalifa to muslimin nahi maanta. So this is what happened. Imam Hussain alayhi salam was doing his duty. And you know, when Imam Hussain left Medina Sharif, he first came onto the grave of his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, you know, he came to the grave of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam really with nice and respectful way. He came, said salam, made dua. And then after he went to the grave of his mother, Hazrat Sayyida Fatima Zahra. But his walk to the grave of his mother was different. When he went to the grave of his mother, Hussein ran to the grave of his mother. And he goes, oh my mother, people are throwing me out of my Medina where I grew up from. So Imam Hussein alayhi salam left Medina. Aur main aapko ek riwayat share karta hoon. Imam Hussein alayhi salam, when he was leaving Medina, my dear brothers and sisters, when he left Medina, on the outskirts he met Hazrat Ibn Mati radiallahu anhu. And this is reported by Tabqat of Ibn Sa'd. Ibn Sa'd died in 270 after Hijrah. So it is not something ko humne ko ghar ke nahi bana li. Ye sahi hai aur purani Tabqat Ibn Sa'd mein. What is Ibn Mati radiallahu anhu? Imam Hussein was going and leaving with who? He was leaving with his sisters, his daughters, his wives, his children. And guess who? Hazrat Ali Asghar was just born. Ali Asghar was just born, who six months later would die at Karbala. So they were leaving. Ibn Mati, Tabqat Ibn Sa'd, he sees Yabna Rasulullah, oh, the son of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, where are you going? Where are you heading? And Imam Hussein alayhi salam tells him that he's going. And he complains, he goes, Ya Hussein, you know, in bi'ri hadhihi qadra shahat ha. That, you know, my well, mera jo kuwa hai, he goes, it's dried up or there's no water in it. He's complaining about water. Tabqat ibn Sa'd. He goes, this well has dried up, there's no water in it. So what shall I do? You know what Imam Hussein says? Hati min ma'ya, or bring some water from it. Whatever you can get from the, just bring a little bit. And when he brought that water, Imam Hussein, he fashariba, thumma raddahu, he drank some of it, thumma raddahu ila al-bi'ri, and then Imam Hussein, little bit water that came out of the well, Imam Hussein alayhi salam drank it, and then threw it back, rinsed his mouth, threw it back into the well. Do you know what happened? Fa'adhaba fa'amha. The water, the well started overflowing with water, and the water was very sweet. So you know this thing, that Imam Hussein alayhi salam, this is his karamat, And this is happening in Tabqat ibn Sa'd, kisi Urdu ki phati hui kitab mein nahi likha, ye wo hamari tareekh ki usooli kitabon mein hai. Imam Hussain alayhi salam, you know, when he was at the battlefield of Karbala and everybody was saying al-atash, you know, water, water, that was by choice. If Hussain wanted, he would have just turned his finger and it would have rained. But there's Mashiyat. You know, when before Imam Hussain died, Sahih Hadith, Nasiruddin al-Albani, I've given a lecture on it, I don't want to repeat it. The angel of rain comes to the Prophet. The angel of rain, Matar, comes to Rasulullah, says, Ya Rasulullah, your son Hussain, innal Husayna yuqtalu bi shattil furat. Ya Rasulullah, your son Hussain will be martyred at the banks of River Euphrates. And this is actually authenticated by a Salafi Wahhabi, Nasiruddin al-Albani Sahib. Sahih Hadith. Why does an angel of rain, Jibreel Kana, we can understand. But why an angel of rain coming to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and telling him, Ya Rasulullah, your son will be killed on the banks of Euphrates? Because the angel of rain even knows it, that darya ke paani inhone band kar diye to kya hua, hum barish to barast aa sakte the. So there was the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was that this is how this sacrifice should be made. The rain, the water was not, they weren't thirsty because they couldn't get water supernaturally, but they were thirsty so they could expose the Yazidis of their crimes. And Imam Hussain was giving the test for his grandfather, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, my dear brothers and sisters, when Imam Hussain alayhi salam, he reaches Makkah, a day before the Hajj, he leaves Makkah because Yazid has sent assassins. He sent these assassins to kill Hussain when he's doing the tawaf. So when somebody kills Hussain, nobody knows who done it. Imam Hussain alayhi salam left Mecca before Hajj. And when Hazrat Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says to him, Ya Hussain, you know, why are you going to? Don't go to Karbala. This so and so will happen to you. You know, it's. And Imam Hussain says, and this is, you can see in Al-Zahabi, Siru Alam in Nubala, and so many other places. It says, Imam Hussain says, Inni ra'aytu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam fil manam. O Ibn Abbas, I saw my grandfather in my dream. Wa amarani bi amrin. And he ordered me a very special thing to do. Bi amrin tanween ta'zim. Amarani bi amrin. And no matter what happens, I will do. You know, people said that Hussain, this is unanimously in all the history books, people say Imam Hussain didn't know what he was getting up to. No, my brothers and sisters. Imam Hussain very well knew what was going on. Rasulullah has even ordered him, he said to Ibn Abbas, I am going, and Rasulullah has told me that no matter what happens, you must carry out this journey. So Imam Hussain leaves. To be honest with you, it's very difficult for me to relate to Karbala. I just find it very weak of my own heart to actually tell you what happened. But you know, Imam Hussain reached Karbala Sharif, and when he got to Karbala, they had tents, all the ladies of the house, all the Sayyidzadis, all the wives, they were all in the tent. The night before, Imam Hussain asked the enemy, give me a night to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they said, okay. So Imam Hussain did the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, got all the people together. And one of the things he said to all his companions, he says to all these people, that look, if you want to leave, you can go. But nobody, of course, was leaving him. Or Urdu mein zara baat karun ke jo Karbala mein shaheed hue hain Banu Hashim, wo sari ki sari aulad hai Hazrat Abu Talib radhiyallahu anhu ki, Aqil ibn Abi Talib, Jafar ibn Abi Talib, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Islam Abu Talib radhiyallahu anhu, J जिन्होंने सरकार की जान को बचाया, सरकार के ऊपर साया किया, इस्लाम को तकवीयत दी अपने बाजू से, अभी वही अबू तालिब है कि जिसकी नस्लें करबला में शहीद हो रही हैं और वही अपने दादे का काम कर रहे हैं। या रसूल अल्लाह, या अली, अबू तालिब रजी अल्लाह अन्हु, एक जल्दी से दलील देता हूँ। कुरान में अल्लाह सुभान व तआला फरमाता है, फमा रमैता इज़ रमाया, मेरे नबी वो पत्थर तुमने नहीं मारा, वो पत्थर मैंने मारा। काम किसका है? अल्लाह ताला का, रसूल पाक का। तो अल्लाह कह रहा कि मैंने पत्थर मारा है। फेल किसका है? एक्शन किसका है? रसूलुल्लाह का। लेकिन अल्लाह ताला कह रहा है मेरा एक्शन है। यदुल्लाह फौका अयदीहिम, जब वो बैत की तो हुजूर पाक के हाथ थे ना सहाबा के हाथ पे, तो अल्लाह कहता है यदुल्लाह फौका अयदीहिम, मेरा हाथ है, आपका हाथ नहीं है, वो मेरा हाथ है। तो हाथ तो रसूलुल्लाह का, एक्शन रसूलुल्लाह का, लेकिन अल्लाह कहता है कि मेरा एक्शन। पत्थर रसूलुल्लाह फेंक रहे हैं, अल्लाह कहता है मेरा एक्शन। तो एक्शन है एक बंदे का, तो अल्लाह उस एक्शन को बना रहा है अपना एक्शन। अब अल्लाह ताला वही कहता है, अलम यजिद का यतीमन फआवा, क्या हमने आपको यतीम नहीं पाया और पना दी। एक्शन किसका था? अबू तालिब का। सारी तफसीरों का इजमा है, पनाह किसने दी थी? अबू तालिब ने। और एक्शन अबू तालिब के एक्शन को अपना एक्शन कौन कह रहा है? अल्लाह सुबहानहू व तआला। तो मेरा यहाँ मिनहाजुल कुरान से इस पूरी दुनिया को चैलेंज है कि पूरे कुरान से मुझे ये दिखा दो कि किसी शख्स वाहिद के लिए अल्लाह किसी काफिर के लिए, किसी काफिर के एक्शन को अल्लाह ताला ने अपना एक्शन कहा। However, coming on Hazrat Abu Talib, relevant of this is Hazrat Abu Talib was the uncle of the Prophet, and in Karbala, all the Banu Hashim, all the family of the Prophet, the larger family of the Prophet, who were killed in Shaheed, Hazrat Muslim bin Aqil in Kufa, all of these people who were killed from the Hashimis were only the children of Abu Talib. His son Aqil, his son Jafar, his son Ali. There were no other uncles or no Hashmis, only Abu Talib. The same Abu Talib who protected the Prophet when the Kuffar was at him to kill him. Abu Talib was a shield to the Prophet. And here Abu Talib's children again are shield to protect Islam. And it's really shameful that people nowadays, you know, people call Hazrat Janabi Abu Talib radiallahu anhu as non-Muslim. That is so sad. Bukhari gives you a couple of reports by Al-Musayyab, right? Al-Musayyab was not even born when Hazrat Abu Talib alayhi salam died. So how can he be a witness? The report from Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu was not even a Muslim when Hazrat Abu Talib died. How can that be reliable? It says in Bukhari Sharif that Hazrat Ummul Mumineen Aisha Siddiqa Islamullah Alayha says that the miraj of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was only spiritual. The whole Mullah Brigade says, no, she wasn't actually married to the Prophet at the time, so therefore she doesn't know. If that argument is valid there, then what about Abu Talib? People who are being witness are not even witness of the circumstances. And what we have, Sirat ibn Ishaq. Ibn Ishaq died in 150 after Hijra. We have a report in there. Bukhari came in 256 after Hijra. Ibn Ishaq was born in 85. Died in 150, the earliest written text evidence in Islam, the earliest one is Sirah ibn Ishaq. There is nothing before it. Written. In that book, it says that Hazrat Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu was at the deathbed of Hazrat Abu Talib, and he says to Hazrat Abu Talib to read, the Hazur Pak asked him, and then Abu Talib radiallahu anhu read the kalima. And Hazrat Abbas witnesses and tells the Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, your uncle has read the kalima and he's become a Muslim. We have exactly the same scenario, exactly the same setting, Hazrat Abbas, exactly the same scenario. 100 years later, the statement of Abbas in that one is that he didn't read the kalima. Aapne dekha copy, kaise plagiarism hua hai. They kept the same plot in of the Sirah ibn Ishaq, and they brought that same plot in Bukhari and other places. Everything is identical, but the only thing, the book that's 100 years before it says he read Kalma, and the book that comes 100 years after says he didn't read Kamla. You think we are stupid? That we would buy your these nonsensical reports. So however, I'm finishing on the last evidence. Since I started on air, I didn't have a major plan to do so. But my cousin tells me that you should. My brother tells me that you should. The thing is this, right? That in the Quran, I'm finishing in 5 minutes. Please bear with me. In the Quran Sharif, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the Prophet, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has little stones, pebbles, he threw at the kuffar, Allah ta'ala says, وَمَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْرَمَا, that, Ya Muhammad, you did not throw those stones. Right? You did not throw them. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَا إِسْتَغْفِيَ آيَةً وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَا, you did not throw those stones, but Allah threw those stones. So, an action which is being carried out by who? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah ta'ala says that your action, your act is not yours, but actually it's mine. I done it. In another place, when Sahaba Ikram did bayat of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the hand of the Prophet was on their hands, Allah Ta'ala says that Yadullahi fawqa aydihim, Ya Rasulullah, your hand is not on the hands of these people, but it's my hand. So it's the hand of the Prophet, Allah Ta'ala says it's my action. So in two places, that it's the action of the Prophet, Allah Ta'ala says it's not your act, it's my act. Similarly, in Surah Al-Duha, it says about Hazrat Abu Talib, Alam yajidka yateeman fa'awa. Even Ibn Kathir, for example, check his tafsir, he says, it means Abu Talib. Allah Ta'ala says, Alam yajidka yateeman fa'awa. Didn't we find you yateem? Alam yateem, you know, like helpless, nobody around, an orphan, fa'awa, and then Allah Ta'ala says, you were protected. We protected you. So here Abu Talib protected the Prophet. So in other words, it is an action of Abu Talib, Allah Ta'ala says, I done it. So my challenge from Minhaj al-Quran International Canada is this, that show me from the Quran Sharif a particular example about a person where Allah Ta'ala has attributed the action of a kafir to his action. I can show you from the Quran where Allah Ta'ala has attributed the action of a particular person as his own action. So this indication also proves that Hazrat Janabi Abu Talib was a Muslim. However, my dear brothers and sisters, it is his aulad also that was martyred and butchered at Karbala by Yazid's army. And I had a lot more to say about the incident of Karbala, but due to the shortage of time, I think this much is sufficient. Aur aakhir mein main dua karta hoon ke ghulame fatah badro hunain likh dena. Aapki mere saath dua hai na, ghulam e fatah badro hunain likh dena, na ya sogwar e shah e mashriqain likh dena, agar tamam wasiyat na meri yaad rahe, mere kafan pe faqat ya Hussain likh dena.